G'day, I'm Dr. Peter Price of Classroom Professor. Welcome to this video. The topic this week is counting fractions along a number line. And the worksheets that go with the video come from this book, which is our Classroom Professor Gadgets worksheets book for the gadget called Fraction Counter. So the gadgets are a set of software tools that we have on our website that are interactive online software tools. So the idea behind them is to help students to develop their thinking and to develop conceptual understanding for the various topics. So far, most of them are about fractions because we know how difficult those are. And this particular piece of software has a screen that looks, a bit like that. So it has a number of whole shapes and fractional shapes and a number line underneath, and the students can count along the number line. So the worksheets themselves this week are a sort of follow-up exercise. They look like this. So there are number lines with symbols and the students have to fill in the blanks. There are no pictures, no regional models or anything like that that are represented here, but of course you could supplement what the students do with these particular worksheets with pictures and diagrams, and I'm going to talk about that on the screen. So what we're trying to do here is to familiarize students with common fractions and specifically with sequences and how the numbers change as we go on, adding fractional parts. So we'll have done number lines with whole numbers and numbers of tens and hundreds and probably decimal fractions at some point as well. But when we're looking at common fractions, of course, the pieces are different depending on the size of the fraction. So the example I've chosen for this this time on the screen is sixths. So here we have some numbers along a number line. One of the activities for students is to work out the size of the pieces and then the name for the pieces and then the symbols for the pieces. So if you look at this here from 0 to 1, we've got a number of lines here between them and the same up to 2 and to 3, and then there's two extras and we move on. Notice, of course, and this is obvious to an adult, if you simply count the lines, you'll get the wrong answer if you say that's the number of pieces. So there are 5 vertical strokes between the 0 and the 1, but there are 6 even spaces. So there's no way around that. It's just what I like to call the fence post question. If you have a problem solving question where you say there's a fence, a certain that needs to go along a boundary and it's a certain length and the posts are this far apart, how many posts will there be? If you simply divide the two numbers, you get one less than you should because there are posts at both ends. So we have, in some mathematical contexts, we need to count the spaces and not just the dividing line between them. I found even adults find that difficult sometimes from doing graphing and things like that. So that's a particular point that you'll need to emphasize with students, I suspect, because oftentimes students get that part wrong. So we need to say, how many spaces are there? What are we going to call them? There are 6 spaces. So we could even write it like this. One whole equals 6 spaces, and we're going to call them sixths. Why do we call them sixths? Because there are 6 of them. How do we write them? Well, they look like that. They've got a 6 on the bottom. All right. So we could, I'm not going to because they're too small, but I could write the symbols that are in there. In the exercises, you'll find that there are some symbols that are here and some that are missing. Actually, I will write some. So let's have 1/6, 3/6, 4/6. Okay. And that's not very neat. I apologize. And up here, we might have 1 and 2. That's a bit neater. 1 and 4/6, 2. And 1/6. As I said, there's not a lot of space here to fill them all in. So then the exercise in the worksheets is to have the students fill in the blanks. We should point out immediately that you could do this without understanding fractions, because this is 1/6 and this is 3, this is 4, then there's a gap. If we just fill in the blanks, if we just see there's a 6 on the bottom of each one, and if all we did was to just put 6 there and 6 there, and there's going to be something with a 6 there and something with a 6 there, and then fill in the gaps and go, this is 1 something, 3, 4 something, it must be 2 and 5. We don't want to the students to simply fill in the blanks by looking for the pattern in the symbols. We want them to think about the size of the numbers. So what I would much rather do is say, there's a sixth. What's it going to look like when we have another one? There's two sixths. Let's write the symbol for that one. What's this one going to be? Oh, look, what other fraction is that equal to? That's equal to a half, and you can see that's halfway between the zero and the one. So we'll talk about the fractions as we go. There are four sixths. What's the next one going to be? Five sixths. Why don't we have one here that says six sixths? Isn't that what that is? Yes, it is. But have a look, it's the same as the whole. So that's why we have the whole, and it doesn't actually say six sixths. But we could. So here we could write six sixths. This will be five sixths and two sixths. All right, so all along the way, we'll be talking to our students about what it means, and especially talking about what happens when we get to the transition from one number of wholes to the next one. So for example, one and four sixths, one and five sixths. What's the next one? Two. Then we have two and one sixth, two and two sixths, so on and so on. Two and five sixths, three. So that, in whole numbers, we call that regrouping. So you get, you know, 57, 58, 59. What's the next one? 60. Why 60? Because we've got a group of 10. We make it into a group of 10. We've got 10 ones. We make it into a group of 10, call it six tens. It's 60. Then we count on. Then we have another transition at 69 to 70. It's exactly the same thing here. Mathematically the same process, but the number of pieces is different. And the tricky bit, I think, about common fractions is not that we've got to do that, but that it changes every time. So that when we're doing fourths, we get up to 3/4, and then the next one is a whole number. If we're doing twelfths, we get up to 11/12, and then there's a whole number, and so on. And it varies, obviously, for each denominator. All right, so the exercises, I just want to reiterate what I said before. They can look a little bit mechanical. They can, students could almost guess what goes in the middle before you even teach them about it. But we want to avoid that sort of guessing. We want them to think about it. And we're going to need to ask questions. You know, how do you know that's that one? What happens when you do this? Where's the transition? You know, questions of that style. All right, so we finished this video. I hope you've enjoyed it, and I'll talk to you next time.